welcome everybody to the 14th, semi at this point, annual cosplay contest!
How's it going? How's the first half of the weekend? Alright, you guys ready to see some cosplay?
Yeah!
We are ready to give you some cosplay. So, first up, we want to introduce everyone to our very talented, very crafty, very cool, very friendly judges. So, we'll get right on to that. If you want to come on over here. First up, we want to introduce to you our judge, Papa Bear.
I've been doing this about 10 years now, and I love Anime Milwaukee. It's the best con in the world.
All right, what exactly do you like to look for when you're judging? Like, what are you a creativity guy, or are you a wow factor guy?
I like creativity. I like seeing different materials being used in different ways. The main thing for me is, like, as long as you have fun with it, you have passion about it, then you're a winner no matter what goes on in the contest.
Thank you. And up next, our judge, La Vie Cosplay. So welcome, thank you so much for being one of our judges this evening, and what originally got you into cosplay?
Actually, it was Kevin Lilliard's website. Back in like the late 90s, I used to scour the internet and look at cosplay photos and be like, man, I really want to do that.
And then you did.
And then I did.
And what's your favorite piece that you've made recently?
Recently, that's a rough word. Pandemic. So my favorite piece is usually my next piece, but my most favorite recent piece, my partner and I, who unfortunately is visiting us virtually, everybody say hi, Elle.
Hi! They're on a computer right down here.
Yes. We participated in the pre-qualifier for the International Cosplay League in Spain, so we are your current U.S. representatives.
Nice.
And we did garments from Magi, the Labyrinth of Magic, Judar, and Kogyoku Ren, based off of their traditional garments made with all natural materials.
Super awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You may take your place of honor.
Me turn. All right, next I'm going to introduce Judge A.K. Wiro. Absolutely beautiful, nice, short, sweet, to the point, love it.
Gorgeous. Thank you so much for being here with us tonight. As you're one of our guest judges, you do have a judge's feature. What is that called?
Judge's feature?
Your special, the special prize that you're giving out.
Right, my personal category for the Judge's Choice Award to those who know my work, I have a catchphrase called repeat till cry, and my Judge's Choice Award title is Those Who Repeat It Till Cry, and I'll be looking for the most painfully repetitive process used in the costume that I'll see tonight.
A little representation for all of us crafters who like to go until our fingers bleed. Thank you so much. Next up, another one of our guest judges, Nipa Dubs.
Hello.
Hello. How are you this evening?
I got a mic.
Do you have something special you would like to tell the audience?
Hello, audience. Thank you for being here. There are many ways you can spend your Saturday night, but you're spending it the best way possible here at this anime convention.
So, question I want to ask you. This is a very ornate, beautiful, incredible cosplay. Remind our audience who you are.
I am Afino Lewr from Final Fantasy XIV Online, MMO, free trial up to Heaven's Word right now. Can you get level to level 60?
Say that 5 times fast. And how long exactly did this exact cosplay take you?
This took me a week because I procrastinated and don't do what I do. Learn from me, make your cosplay ahead of time, don't wait.
True words have never been spoken. Thank you very much. That's for us, not you. All right, next up is our judge, Phil Misano.
I give out my two. I feel like I'm on Miss America.
You are Miss America!
To that end, what is your ambition? You can't say world peace.
Oh, jeez. World peace and cosplay.
Oh, good answer. Loading. Can you talk a little bit about your Judge's Choice Award?
Ooh, so, I'm like a different type of cosplayer. I'm not as crafty and amazingly talented as the people that were just before me. So what I look for in cosplay might be a little bit different. What I really admire in people is when they take a character and they make it into something with their own personal touch, which is something that I like to do as well. I love like closet cosplays and like original character stuff. So I was looking for someone who kind of had their own little creative spin on a character from whatever they're cosplaying as.
Love it.
Yeah.
That's the original spin.
Thank you.
And final question before you run away.
Oh, I thought I was done. Okay.
Do we still look good with those contacts?
You look amazing with these contacts.
Right answer. Thank you for
that. You look amazing without them too.
Very nice. They gave us a nice little script. Two years ago. Time. We didn't get a scripty thingy, we didn't get preparation, we came out here like a day before we were supposed to go on stage and they handed us the mics and went, good luck! We've had a lot more time to prepare.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I had 35 cosplayers written on my arm and I'm really short, so.
All right, so why don't we get the show on the road for everybody? You want to see some cosplays?
Before we get started, let's do a little dry run. What are you gonna do when you see a cosplayer of a character that you absolutely love?
It sounds like they said go bananas.
That's right. What are you gonna do if you see a cosplay of a character that you don't really love?
Sounds like go banana split? I'll work on it, I'm sorry.
And what are you gonna do if you see a cosplay of a character that you've never heard of?
Because regardless of if you know these characters, if you've seen these characters one time in a very obscure anime, all of these people work super, super hard to put on a cool show just for you guys. So without further ado, if you're ready in the back, if we're ready in the front, let's get the show on the road. First up, I would like to introduce Harpy Ida as Ida Clawthorn from The Owl House. Long ramp. Yeah.
first cosplay, we have Captain Puffy from Dream SMP. Sound crazy, but with the fur, that looks really comfortable. Up next, we have No Girlfriend Due to Cosplay as their original character, King Jason. If those Barbie movies were as formative for you as they were for me, no wonder you do cosplay now. Next up, we have Jellyfish Adele as Azra Aldazar from the Arcana.
Ladies, and gentlemen, turn the lights down low and shut your faces as I wrap you in the cozy blanket of a story. A story as heartwarming and soft as a mother's kiss. Or is it? Shh. Once upon a time, there was a costume. But it wasn't any costume, children. It was a cosplay costume. A costume to build and forge friendships with. Fun for craftsmen and competitions all around. And above all, was the maker of this cosplay, Crafty Cosplayer. Say hi to Crafty. The cat's meow, or the cat's me wow. Get it? And they were the walking definition of handsome and wholesome gentle person. They had a whole boatload of friends. Now this boat wasn't any boat, it was more of a ship, a veritable friendship it was, made by great craftsmen, one and all. Now one fine morning, 6 months before con, Crafty and pals decided to try out new exciting costumes. What fantastic wonders would they try to do this time? Perhaps they'd try a giant dragon cosplay, or perhaps they'd find a fun competition. Perhaps they'd find a 14-person group cosplay and join forces to enter a fun cosplay competition with a dragon. Who knew? But it didn't matter. So long as Crafty and friends were together, there were 3D printer files to draft and reference photos to be shared. Now, the spring con date was like any other first day on a project. Spirits were uncrushingly high and everyone was singing and having a jolly time. When suddenly the cosplay project was all like surprise! A huge, massive structural problem like a storm of fabric brewed out of nowhere. Whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. Boy, that looks like a problem. Whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. There was the yelling, and the crying, and the mental breakdowns. When suddenly the problem was solved and the storm calmed. Did everyone make it? Asked Crafty. I would hate if any one of you got frustrated and left, Crafty continued. But solving a problem in a project can be very misleading, children. Never turn your back on the rest of it while fixing the problem, because all the cosplay was like, psych! And Crafty and friends realized it was only 2 days left before con, and they had half the costumes to build. The sewing machine was bouncing, buckling, and breaking. Fabric painted thermoplastic was going that way and this way and that. There were so many sleepless nights and quick fixes, and oh, it was so scary. I think they even pulled out the hot glue gun. Oh, yep, there it is. Everyone was working so hard when suddenly Crafty said, hold on to your butts, craftsmen. Convention ho! And they packed the ship and traveled to con, hoping to finish their cosplay in the room, just as was foretold in their fate books of fate. But this isn't the end of the story, good children. They finished their projects, went to craftsmanship judging, and are presenting themselves before you. So stay tuned to find out the lovely endings of Crafty and the wonderful craftsmen and performers of the SS Friends Craftsmanship.
We've all had a project like that, right? Oh, thank God, it's not just me. Anybody else pick up a new hobby in the past 2 years for no reason at all?
Anyone get into paper making? Interesting, I thought I was the only guy. Hey, solidarity.
Next up, we have from Cos Creation Studio, Link from Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess.
Absolute classic. Oh, love those games. Alyssa Noel is up next as, oh, perfect, Tsukino Usagi from Sailor Moon.
This year is Magical Girl, right? I don't just wear this tiara for fun. Cool. Up next, we have Violet Sparkles cosplay as Tao Kaka from Blaze Blue.
Yeah.
bit too much spotlight, so we moved down here. Now all of your pictures will be a little bit more personal. Not your average rage nerd cosplay is up next as Nyang Cat from the internet meme, of course.
I love a good rainbow cape, I do. Up next, we have the Oda Queens. Have you ever noticed that a lot of the mecha pilots in anime are young children? One day, several of these kids receive a mysterious invite. The Oda Queens present, You Are Not Alone.
Hey, Duo. What are you doing here?
Well, I got this invitation.
So did I.
Hey, Zero Twos. Is this the teenagers with attitude who also happen to pilot giant robots meetup?
Yeah. Who parked a lion outside?
Ah, good. Most of you are here.
Who are you, old hag?
No manners, huh, kid? I guess that's what happens when you just give giant robots to children. But that's the point of this gathering. I know what you all need.
New C4 explosives?
To love myself?
Parents.
Wow. Now what you need is an older, wiser leader. And I just so happen to be available.
We're out. Me too.
Do you validate parking?
No. Just humor me. Listen to the pitch.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Rita Repulsa, in an act of desperation.
My husband and I had a plan that couldn't fail.
Why did her voice change?
The monsters we made were destined to prevail. My minions and I had a paddle a week at least.
Oh, yes.
But everyone is unfortunately deceased. I know it's sad, of course, but I'll manage to get through. For at my command are my knowledge, my power, and you.
Watch this. Please forgive the crudity of these models. I didn't have time to build them.
Do it alone. So if you'd and you'd then you'd, 'cause I can't do it alone.
Hey, now where's your secret base?
On the moon.
How much are we being paid?
You got to that really soon, but I'd go. Then you'd go. We'd go. And then those Power Rangers would be no more. Beaten, stunned, and stamped on the floor. Angel Grove would be begging no more.
Hold it. Are we the bad guys in this scenario?
Yeah. Which side did you think I was on?
But we're all... maybe not you. We're heroes.
Yes, but was being the hero ever a decision you made for yourself? Or were you drafted into some old man's war? At least I'm being upfront about who I am and giving you a choice.
I'm sold. I'm in.
What?
She gets it. I don't think I've had any role models in my entire life. I'm willing to be a monster of the week.
Is there dental?
Yes.
I'm in too.
Sure, why not?
Great.
Now Rita staged a comeback, and I'll get these kids back on track. I'm ready to go ransack the world.
Come on, kids, let's get ice cream.
Yay.
Thank you.
been debating since the theme is magical girl, what exactly makes a magical girl? And what I was thinking, what I've been trying to pitch, is that different things don't have to necessarily be magical girls to be magical girls. Would anyone agree with me that Ichigo Kurosaki from Bleach is a magical girl? Would anyone agree with me that Beetlejuice is a magical girl? Would anyone agree that Inuyasha's sword, not Inuyasha, but Inuyasha's sword Tetsuya is a magical girl? That's all you.
And I owe you 10.
Next up, we have Nolachu as the Galar Nurse Joy from Pokemon.
Next up, we have Mirai Dango as Ruby Kurosawa from Love Live Sunshine. All agree any cosplay that lights itself up is basically witchcraft. Next up from Facade Costuming, we have Mimikyu from Pokemon.
Thank you.
I think it's safe to say those 6 years paid off, Echo. Wow. Up next, from Platinum Bubbles, we have Dina from Bizengast.
Oh, great time for me to find out. I am hungry. Next up, we have Frega. Frega as Shannon from Umineko no Nakakorani. Video games for life. Excellent question for a video game cosplayer.
I guess there ain't no in between, is there?
No.
Mama, I have to say video games on that one.
Video games it
is.
Thank you, Kai.
Wait. Something for you. Keep asking questions. Okay. Keep asking questions.
Next up, we have a little piece of trivia for you. Which of the Sailor Senshi members is actually a cyborg?
I've never watched Sailor Moon.
Correct answer.
No! Anyway.
Sorry, what was that, Anime Milwaukee?
No!
That's right. And for you, my dear. What is your favorite mythical creature?
Oh, gosh. I don't know. Probably like a hippogriff. That was cool.
Awesome. Thank you so much. You may collect your prize and return your seat.
I bought a whole bunch of cute little, like, princess wands. They reminded me a little bit of, like, the sticks from Sailor Moon, so everybody can be a Sailor Scout today.
And I take it we're ready to give Shannon her walkthrough one more time? All right, once again, give it up for Frega as Shannon from Umineko no Nakakoro ni.
Frega, please. Excellent. Next Cyborgt, I don't know if it's a typo or a really cool name, as an original character.
My recurring Jurassic Park nightmare would come back this year. Next up, give it up for Maki Roni as Circus Miku from 2019 Vocaloid. Spooky cosplays this year. Up next from Steampunkery, we have Steampunk Overhaul from My Hero Academia.
Human race. original content.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Me too. I mean, look at me. I'm 10 years out of theaters, and I always thought...
What?
No, it sounds stupid.
Aw, come on.
When I was little, I thought I would have...
What?
A feel-good sequel, just like Toy Story 3.
Oh.
But now I'm getting old, and as you can see, I don't.
Nope.
Oh well. It sucks to be me.
No.
It sucks to be me.
No.
Sucks to be passed over for a living spork named Forky. Sucks to be me.
Oh, you think your life sucks?
I think so.
Your problems aren't so bad. I'm kind of pretty, and pretty damn smart.
You are.
Thanks. I like romantic things like music and art. And as you know, I have a gigantic heart. So why don't I have a girlfriend? Ross, it sucks to be me.
It sucks to be me. It sucks to be Merida.
And Elsa.
To not have a sequel.
To not have a date. It sucks to be me.
People can get. We've been the best of buddies ever since that day we met. So he knows lots of ways to make me really upset. Oh, every day is an aggravation. Come on, that's an exaggeration. You leave your clothes out. You hide me up in your hair.
Oh yeah? You do such useless things like ironing your underwear.
You make that very small apartment we share a hell. You. That's why I'm in hell too.
It sucks to be me.
No, it sucks to be me.
It sucks to be me.
It sucks to be me.
Is there anybody here it doesn't suck to be?
It sucks to be me.
Sorry to bother you, but I'm looking for a place to stream.
Why are you looking way out here?
Well, I started in theaters, but right now everything's closed due to COVID. But this site looks like it's open. Oh, and look, an out streaming sign.
Milwaukee is in no way affiliated with the Walt Disney Corporation, nor do they endorse the content or the cosplay content. Up next, from Smorg, we have the Imperial Guard from Star Wars Attack of the Clones.
Make sure people don't miss the ramp. Whoop. All right, next up we have Ritzy as Pyro Abyss Mage from Genshin Impact.
Nice dear, we have Princess Annalise from Barbie.
Hello,
cosplays. Now I gotta ask. So, quick cheers. Whose favorite is Barbie Rapunzel? My people. Who likes Barbie Swan Lake best? Some of the older ones. 12 Dancing Princesses? Well, I figured you would. And,
Princess and the Pauper.
Princess and the Pauper. Does anyone like Fairytopia the best?
Yes.
I got something in my ear here. Is it this? I don't know what it is, but I was told I had to pick it up.
Thank you.
Oh, it's from Mimikyu. Thank you. All right, since I'm still holding the script, that means next up is Scapegoat as Demon Oriza from Overwatch.
Lady with big skull shoulders.
Can I get your number, hot demon lady?
Up next, we have Vue with two Y's as Chongyun from Genshin Impact.
Video games. How many of you would recommend Genshin Impact? Is that good? Do they have like challenging monsters? Do they have like what is it? Sandbox? Like you can walk around? Are the characters cute? Yeah! Good to know. Next up is Nina London as Miss Anniversary from Sakizu Illustrated.
Beautiful work, Nina. Your and your candle's posture is impeccable. Up next, we have Terezi Dreamer from Homestuck. Beautiful, beautiful work. You know what? The combination of fashion, of musical acts, of theater acts, and comedy, cosplay contests are really the closest you can get in the modern world to vaudeville. So there's that. Next up, we have the NCR Ranger from Fallout New Vegas. From space. Okay, next up we have the legend of Randy as Guts from Berserk. Chainsaw Man.
I did it again, I did it again. I just keep looking at people's cosplays like this. So I have no idea what's going on ever. Next up we have Radically Average as Krona Gorgon from Soul Eater.
Alright, this is gonna date me, but Soul Eater is the first anime I ever watched all the way through. Cute. Up next, we have Asher BB as Jinx from Arcane and League of Legends.
That goes into a lot of the weapons I see up on the stage, like the shark cannon, so cool. I'm kind of showing off the fact that I haven't watched Arcane, I haven't played League of Legends. I'm behind on the times, I've been stuck in that Hatsune Miku game. Next up, we have a skit from Makeshift Cosplay. The question being, can Tanjiro's flashy training be enough to win this contest? Let's find out. Tonight. Next up, we have Bakugo Katsuki from My Hero Academia. Thank you.
They just give us box wine for being MCs. All right, on the count of three, I'm gonna ask you, what would your sidekick, animal sidekick, be if you were a magical girl, and you're all gonna yell it out. Ready? One, two, three.
Did someone say shark?
Next up, we have Tiny Cryptid.
Introduction, of course. Next up, we have MK cosplay as Winter Zelda from The Legend of Zelda. So another fun fact, when JJ and I aren't emceeing cosplay contests, we're usually in the artist's alley, and we play the shop music from Legend of Zelda. Woo! So, it makes you want to buy stuff. You gotta make me blush.
Up next from Spacey Designs, we have Klee from Genshin Impact. So it sounds like we have some Attack on Titan fans out there. Yeah. You'll love this, it's a Genshin Impact skit. Introducing Joey Blonde Wolf as Zhongli and the Phoenix Joe as Child in this skit called Love Arrow.
So, Zhongli, have you ever been in love?
No. And we need to focus on more important matters. Like you buy me stuff.
Well, because I got a new bow with a new power, whoever my target hits will make them fall in love with the first person they see. And it's pink!
I'm leaving.
Please, why not try it?
Because you're the only one here, stupid!
That's why it'd be fun. Be with you.
Listen, I don't think this is a good idea.
Wait, look behind you. Isn't that my wallet?
Really? Where? You did not just...
And you're looking at me.
Oh, shut up, child. I'm sorry.
Stephanie and Emmy, two of the participants, actually got engaged. Right here at Anime Milwaukee.
And then they fought to the death.
Back to business. Next up, we have Stefano as Stefano in a series of unfortunate events.
Well, hello there. My name is Stefano. Italian man. I am the assistant to famed herpetologist Dr. Montgomery Montgomery, and it should be noted here that I am absolutely, positively, for certain, definitely not Count Olaf. Well, you see, Count Olaf has a one thick eyebrow and short little beard, whereas I have no eyebrow. If you were to think that I and Count Olaf were the same person, well, perhaps you should reevaluate your hypothesis.
That guy seems so trustworthy. I wonder if he has any advice on what to do with my family's large fortune they left me. Next up, we have Mary Saotome from Kakegurui. I want you to give a great big Amki welcome. If you didn't blow out your voice at the drag show last night, do it now. To Tanjiro Kamado from Demon Slayer.
Some entertainment up here. I was also told to let the cosplayers know that there are cameras up in front here, so before you like go anywhere or do anything, just give yourself 10 seconds while I think on stage for a last promenade. No, wait, I'm sorry, I'm kidding. What?
Bring the judges on stage.
Bring the judges on, not cosplayers, sit.
Never mind. Okay. I'm gonna call this out. Judges, stay where you are. Booth, make up your mind. Thank you. We're gonna call the following three cosplayers to the stage to hang out with us while we set up for halftime. Laughing Rat Cosplay, Timeline Cosplay, and That's Nice Deer. Give them a round of applause. Come on up, guys. While we get ready for halftime.
Hope you've been studying. You did read the book? You did. You were ready for the test?
Did they give you guys the study guide?
No. Oh, the fearful expressions say it all.
Would we hurt you?
Yes! Wow. Yes!
Thank you.
Who said that? Hello. I don't want to mess with it. Never mind. Good, and I didn't hear anything, and you're so cool. Are you gonna ask the questions? You're the one with the questions.
Are you gonna intro me while I get the cards ready?
So Graham has these really cool cards that have a whole bunch of like neat little interview questions that we came up with just to have some fun with a couple of our cosplayers up here.
So first of all, we'll have you remind the lovely folks down there who you are, and we might ask you a couple of questions about what you have with you today. Not the chocolate, the outfit. Actually, no, I wanna know, what kind of chocolate is that?
Lindt milk chocolate.
Yeah. You get a bite? My loving husband, everyone. Oh, like I'd leave you.
Right in front of my face.
Yay.
All right, so first of all, I'd like to say that you look gorgeous. I think we can all agree that you look gorgeous. You've probably been asked this before, you've probably been asked 1,000 questions about this outfit, but what was your favorite part of this outfit?
Honestly, I love the shoes. I would actually wear the shoes just, like, out.
They're gorgeous. Yeah, show them off.
I admit, the body looks really good in this dress.
Beautiful.
About how long did it take you to make this particular outfit?
This has been an off and on project since 2019.
2 years in the making. Fantastic.
Interrupted for a little while there.
And remind me of your cosplay name.
That's nice, dear.
Dear with two E's, like the Bucks mascot. It's very clever. Once again, you look gorgeous. Give us a little twirl. And what was your favorite part of this?
I like reusing garbage that I found and stuffing it into my stays.
That's awesome. I live in Bayview, so all my neighbors compost. So being sustainable like that, that's awesome. Long, and you are Timeline, correct?
Yes, Timeline Cop.
And what was your favorite part of this outfit?
The favorite part of this outfit, honestly, was making my sleeves.
You love a big flowy sleeve. Are those heavy?
They are a little bit, but I have stuff stuffed into them.
They double as pockets?
They do.
Awesome. It has pockets! All right, and starting on our trivia. So some of these are open-ended, some of them are really hard. We'll see what I pull. Oh, nice. Name an anime that you haven't watched yet that you really want to see.
Oh.
I assure you the crowd is nice and there are no wrong answers. Don't ruin this!
So I'm a spider, so what?
Ooh. Has anyone seen that? And would you recommend it? Holy cow. All right.
Spider.
Are you going to ask the hard questions?
It's funny.
Princess Annalise, you up for a little challenge?
I'm so scared.
so scared.
Me too. Which popular house techno band's music was featured in the 2003 anime movie Interstellar 5555?
Interstellar.
42.
That's correct. For those of you out in the house who don't know, which I hope is all of you, it's Daft Punk. Because of my lovely wife. And finally, our dear laughing rat, would you rather have a bowl of never-ending soup or a cup of never-ending coffee?
What kind of soup, what kind of coffee?
Your choice.
God.
Soup.
I'm gonna go soup.
Coffee.
All right, audience, make some noise for soup. Make some noise for coffee.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm divided on it too.
Impressed.
All right, thank you all for playing. You will receive your prizes now.
It's a match, pick a batch. Thank you. Thank you. You may go have a seat. Thank you so much for playing.
One more round of applause for our lovely cosplayers.
I gotta step these back in. Since I still have so many left over, if you happen to hit me up after this, I don't know, and you want like your own special little princess wand, just let me know. I bought them for you guys.
And without further ado, I announce our musical guest. Yes?
Yes, do you guys want music?
Yes. All right, let's see if we can get a little drum roll going. Without further ado, your halftime musician, Kieran Strange!
But I love the ado! Why would you take my ado from me? I love ado.
Ado?
I love much ado, especially right. About nothing.
With a
How
whole
is everybody doing? Give a round of applause for your hosts. They are so fantastic. JJ and Graham? Oh my gosh, I'm so excited to come chill with you for a little bit. The judges are deliberating. It is terrifying back there. They're saying such awesome things about all of the cosplayers. How many Tanjiros do we ever get? Never enough, right? Never enough Tanjiros. All right, y'all, my name's Kieran Strange. We're gonna rock out for a tiny, weeny, weeny little bit while the judges are figuring stuff out. I have to dedicate this one to Griffin Burns. You gotta go check out his band. New girlfriend. Yeah? Like Scott Pilgrim. It's good. Just consider this a giant skit. And if you don't like it, just pretend it's a really messed up episode of Doctor Who. Yeah.
truth is just a rule that you convey. You crack the whip, shape shift and trip.
Certain things you can't do until you've gotten, you know, like the work out of the way. I love my work, I'm pretty lucky, but now I can drink again! Oh, if you're under 18, or no, it's 21 here, isn't it? Sorry. If you're under 21, it's not that big a deal, don't worry about it. You lose your interest in a few years, trust me. So I actually want to do one that, like, is kind of, like, important right now. I'm trying not to pay too much attention to the Beijing Olympics, mostly because it's in Beijing, but also because American coverage tends to just focus on the American teams, and I'm kind of like, I want to know how everyone is doing, but I caught the hockey game last night, right? Y'all, like, kicked Canada's butt, okay? And I am a proud Canadian, but you have not beat us in 10 years at the Olympics. Hats off, America. Y'all did a great job. And the ice skating part of the Olympics is probably my favorite part. Right? Like, Nathan Chen. Oh, wow. Everyone who doesn't follow the Olympics is like, what is he? Doctor Who, Doctor Who, Doctor Who. It's okay. Anyway, I first heard this song at a convention. And I had a bunch of people telling me I needed to watch the anime. And I hadn't done it, because that's just who I am, and I'm sorry. I'm too old to change at this point. I thought it was a phase. It's not changed, so I think it's just who I am. I finally gave it a watch after I heard the song performed. And the song was performed, I believe it was during an idol contest. And then I was invited to do the halftime show at this con at their masquerade, so I was like, oh, why don't I bring the winners of the idol contest and they can come perform with me? Not because I'm sneaky and wanted less work, but because I thought it'd be a cool experience for them. It was like lots of people, like all of your good selves here, gathered to watch some really good cosplay and to really like pay homage. I've only ever seen that word written, sorry. Pay homage to that side of conventioning. Because like it's why a lot of us come to conventions or got into this, is because we wanted somewhere to wear a cosplay. So I brought the guy up, and his name's Sacred Skittles. You can find him on Twitter and Instagram. And he performed this song that broke my bloody heart. And he won because he was really good. And I was sitting backstage at the cosplay show, and he's performing it. I just started crying. And my guitarist is like, dude, are you all right? I was like, this song is so beautiful. I was like, I can't. I gotta work. Okay. Actor kicked in. The song is beautiful, and it always makes me think of conventions, and it makes me think of how I feel when I'm here. It was just such a beautiful moment in time for me, and I wish I could take you all there and experience that same feeling I felt of like inspiration and warmth and love, but I can't. So the next best thing I can do is at least cover the song for you. I'll do my best. Just pretend it's sung by Sacred Skittles, because he is so fucking dead. All right. I love all y'all.
Never too late, I close my eyes, tell myself that my dreams will come true. There'll be no more darkness when you believe in yourself. You are unstoppable where your destiny lies. Dancing on the blade, you set my heart on fire. Don't stop us now, the moment of truth. We were born to make history.
Yeah.
I love it. Oh, it's a good time. Oh, man. I want to thank you all for coming out. I know I said it briefly earlier, but for coming out to support the cosplayers. I was, like, super thrilled, and I'm not just talking them up because they paid me $5 before the show. That was for something else. I honestly walked in, and I was like, I haven't been to many masquerade shows, which is why I really like doing the halftime, because I get to see the freaking cosplay. And I never get to do that, and it's my favorite part, so... Getting to come here and watch the show. Yeah, massive round. Actually, do that so we can catch my breath. Massive round of applause for the cosplayers. Thank you. Thank you there, my little comrade down there. I much appreciate it, my little colleague. We're in the same boat here. I love that I get to come here, and I was really awesomely impressed with the fact that Novice and Journeyman and Skits and Master were like all mixed in together. To me, it felt less of a like parade of who is better and more of a just like, hey, let's sit back and enjoy the cosplay. So like, massive props to the team who put this together. The hosts are amazing. They have been so, so much fun. The team backstage are working so hard. They're so serious. They're like spies back there. They've got their radios and they're like, yeah, we're good to go when you are. Yes, I have Sierra right here. I'm sorry, it's Karen, I'm sorry. Everyone who asked me this weekend, don't worry, it's a trap for Americans. I'm considering a rebrand, it's okay. I love y'all. So yeah, no, they're working, they're busting their butts back there, I really appreciate it. Front house sound, everybody is working so hard together to put this show together because it's not easy. Judges are killing it back there. They're so well dressed, it's intimidating. I threw on whatever I could fit on the plane. That was like, I had a backpack and I just started sticking things in it. I like this. Everyone who's cosplayed this weekend, even if you haven't been up here, just props to you, like pun not intended. It's cold. You know, I've noticed that coming up from Dallas. It's a little chilly. So massive props for anyone who is cosplaying in the cold, as well as just like, I always say, there's two parts to cosplay that are difficult. One is constructing the costume. It's very difficult, right? The other half is actually wearing it, right? And that's the part I struggle with, because after half an hour, I'm like, okay, I'm done. The novelty has worn off. I do not want to be Iron Man anymore. I'm good, but thanks. I nearly wore it downtown to a protest until I realized I wouldn't be able to run away.
Big mistake, big mistake.
I'm coming. So yeah, that didn't happen. But yeah, massive props to everybody who is out there wearing their fandom and wearing their hearts on their sleeves. Y'all are just super killing it. So I wrote this parody a little while ago, and I like bringing it back now, even though the song is like from my days past, I suppose. It's not super old. I'm not gonna expose you to any Guns N' Roses. It's okay. Wait, is Guns N' Roses old? Somewhere, someone who's like 40 was like, I don't like him. I don't like him one bit. It's an older parody that I wrote. I've never had the guts to put my parodies online. I'm hoping that's going to change soon. I get really shy like a lot of y'all, and I get scared to put my work out there, so I feel you. But this is one I brought back because of I am just so proud of the Critical Role crowd and the critters. Like, y'all are a force to be reckoned with. Y'all are scary, like, and I'm super happy that it's reignited this love of tabletop role-playing, like, especially Dungeons & Dragons. I only played a little Dungeons & Dragons. I'm a big White Wolf fan myself. Changeling, y'all. So I love bringing this one back because I just want to celebrate the critters and how badass they are, and I'm really happy for y'all. I'm happy for all these new younger generations. Like, I know friends who play with their kids sometimes, and it's incredible. Like, I'm so excited for this. Yes, well done, everybody. So yeah, enjoy a little bit of I pull up my car. If you wanna know how to power game, take control and mess with the DM's brain. I'm taking all the XP and all the treasure we see. He knows he can't stop me.
One person from every Milwaukee suburb. That'd be awesome.
Obscure ones, like a Oconomowoc.
Franklin.
Oh, there are more of them. There are more of them. Somebody wants called desperately. What was that?
Idaho.
Idaho?
Oh yeah, if you're not from Wisconsin. Texas, yeah. Idaho,
Indiana.
Who else wants me to say their state on stage? Everyone.
Ooh.
Colorado. Why did you come here? You know you can't get here. Skis.
Saying
Illinois on stage.
What else is going on? Are we done? Are we good? Did we do it? We did it! Awesome!
Please welcome to the stage your judges.
Just me, his son was going to be there.
It's more!
applause for Tilly, please?
Yeah!
How's everybody doing? Good deal. All right, we're gonna go ahead and start with our judges' choice awards. Do we just wanna start at one end?
Okay, my judge's choice award was the They Who Repeated Till Cry award, and I've chosen to give this to somebody who top-stitched everything in their costume. It was immaculate. It must have taken so much time, and they must have cried a lot, right? So that will go to Spacey Studios as Klee! Where's her thing?
What an amazing show. Can we give it a round of applause for all the contestants real quick? My judges award goes to, my judges award category is walk-on cinema, but like they look like they could just walk right into a movie set and right, get ready to film right away. And this goes to Mikasa Ackerman from Attack on Titan.
Sorry to interrupt. It's been a rough couple years, I think, for all of us. And this person gave me instant boost of serotonin that I think we all kind of needed. So my award is called Oh My God to Megang's Nanecat.
Sort of things. So she picked this character for the infectious energy of a cosplayer, creative use of thrifted garments and items to harvest the fabrics for this costume, and that is this is Genevieve from Barbie and the Dancing Princess.
So for my award, I was looking at foam construction, and I thought it was so cool the work he did. Even though he's a novice, it showed a lot of great skill to put this together. So my award goes to the legend of Randy for his Guts costume.
The show must go on, and this is definitely a show. Are you guys enjoying yourselves? you just deal with it and you go and you rock it anyway. My award is going to Fraga. Not only did we persevere the first time, we came out the second time and rocked it harder, so.
Give it up for all our Judges' Choice winners.
And before we start giving out craftsmanship awards, I just want to say that you guys are all amazing, and I'm really sad that we can't give you all awards. All right, one more round of applause, let's do it.
So first up is our novice category. In third place, Cos Creation for Link. One more time for Link, everybody. Our second place novice winner is Galactic Elephant for the Space Marine. You can just walk to the front of the stage here so you don't have to hit the stairs. Category is Rixie for the Pyro Abyss.
To Seongyeong from Genshin Impact. Our second place journeyman award is going to Steampunkery as Overhaul from My Hero Academia. Cosplay as King Jason.
time.
You were fighting. I don't blame you.
All right, up next we have our Masters category. Give it up for the Masters. All right, in third place, we have That's Nice Dear for Princess Annalise. In the Masters category, facade costuming for Mimikyu Pokemon. In the Masters category, Laughing Rat for Momo.
Can we get a drum roll, please?
All right. Our 2022 Anime Milwaukee Best in Show is Get Loud For Me. Nina London, Miss Anniversary.
You guys, this is your treat. You are all the winners here. Can we get another round of hand for all of our contestants?